Hello, kids. Today we are going to tackle studying a musical score. But I know that it is very difficult for a children like you to study a musical score if you don't know the value of one flat, two flats, or one sharp, and so on. So I will teach you the correct acronym for you to easily remember the value of one sharp up to seven sharps and one flat up to the seven flats. Okay, so let's start with the flat. Again, this is a symbol for a flat. Okay, so if we have one flat, it stands for 4. But the technique that I always inculcate to the mind of my pupils, if it is flat, 4. FF. Okay. Next. Then, 2 flat, it is boys. Okay. Boys. It is letter B. So this is letter F, this is letter B. If it is 3, it is E, which is it, okay? And then if it is number 4 or 4 flats, it is apples. Letter, what letter? Letter A. 5 flats. But 5 flats, it is letter D, which is during. Okay, letter D. And then 6. 6 flats. 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 flats, it is letter G, good. Okay, good. Letter G. And if it is 7, 7 flat, it is letter C, which is climbing. Okay, climbing. So I will repeat the acronym. 4 boys eat apples during good climate, para madaling ma-memorize nila. Okay, sa ating awit na Dignity of Labor, kung makikita ninyo doon, there is one flat at the start of our songs. So, doon sa may pinaka-bukana, no? Isang flat. So, pag isang flat, ibig sabihin, ano-ano niya? What is the letter? Corresponds. So it is letter F, meaning the song is key of F. Okay? Again, the song Dignity of Labor is key of F. So why is it F? Because there is one flat that you can see at the beginning of your song. Now, if it is not a flat, for example, sharp naman, no? So, sharp tayo. O yung sabi ng mga eskwela ay hashtag. Okay, hashtag. Yan. Oh. Pero ito sa music, ito ay sharp. Uh-huh. It is a sharp. So, if it is one, it is letter G. Go. Stands for letter G. Pag dalawa, D, which stands for down. Down. Okay. Letter D. Then, if it is number 3 or 3 sharps, it is letter A. Go down and. Okay. And letter A. And then, if it is 4, if it is number 4, it is letter E. Go down and eat. And if it is 5, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, 5 sharps. It is go down and eat B. Okay, B. It is letter B. And then if it is 6, okay, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 6 sharps. Big letter F, which stands for fruit. Okay, letter F. And the last one, 7 sharps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, it is letter C, the same as 7 flat. It is also letter C, but it is K. Okay, letter C. So, but in the song, sometimes there is no flat. There is no flat and there is no sharp. If there is no flat, there is no sharp, it is key of C. Kasi parehas naman silang pito. Pitong sharps, pitong flats, ay letter C. Kaya pwedeng alisin. So pag nakita natin na wala siyang flats, wala siyang sharps, so siya ay key of C. Malinaw? Sana po may natutunan. Okay, uulitin ni ma'am. Halimbawa, yung dignity of labor natin na song. Okay, pag gumawa tayo ng ating limguhit. O, tinatawag nating stuff. Meron siyang 5 lines and 4 spaces. Ano, nakikita natin. 5 lines and 4 spaces. So, doon sa, paano naman po natin malalaman? Halimbawa po, katulad ng dignity of labor, sabi niyo ma'am, mayroon siyang isang flat at yun ay key of F. Paano natin malalaman kung nasaan ang kanyang do? So, meron tayong dapat ding i-memorize. Okay? So, sa ating space, pataas ay F, A, C, E. Na mabubuo natin ay face. At sa atin namang lines, 5 lines, mula sa baba ang pagbilang papunta sa taas. So, this is the first line. Ito yung 5th line. So, yan ay E, G, B, D, F. Okay, ilitin ko. E, G, B, D, F. Pero kung nalilito ka sa E, G, B, D, F, yan ay pwede natin gawin din ang acronym na every good boy does fun. Okay? Every good boy does fun, which is E, G, B, D, F. Now, so, to find out the do in the key of F, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, the F is located in the first space and fifth line. I will repeat. Letter F is located in the first space and fifth line. So, meaning, the do in the key of F, the do in the key of F is located here. Yon, do. And here, do. Yun po ang gamit natin ng mga titik na yan. Yung ating EGBDF na yan at FACE. Hanggang letter G lang tayo. Yung A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Hindi po pwede makaabot ng H. Hanggang letter G lamang siya. Okay? So, ulitin ni ma'am sa ating pinaka-symbol na ipinakita sa inyo, the F is in the first space and fifth line. So the lower do is here and the higher do is here. Now, why is it that I am inculcating this? So that you can answer the exercise on page 6, what is it? Okay? In the first question there, what is the time signature of the song? So, madali-dali ito. The time signature, yung atin lamang palakumpasan. No? Yung dalawang number na makikita natin sa unahan ng awit na parang fraction. Ang kaibahan lang, wala siyang guhit sa gitna. Kasi pag ginuhitan sa gitna, fraction na yon. Pag walang guhit sa gitna, ang tawag natin is time signature or bilinggalaw. Next, what is the key of the song? Yan na nga, kaya ko binigay to. What is the key of the song? So, uulitin ni ma'am, ang tatandaan lamang natin ay yung mga symbol na flats and sharp na ibinigay ko kanina. And then, what is the first and last note of the song? So, titingin kayo doon sa awit kung ano yung first note. Pag sinabi nating note, yun yung mga tinuro sa inyo kanina na yung kinds of notes like the whole note, half note, quarter note, eighth note, and sixteenth note. The rest, ganun din. The whole rest, half rest, quarter rest, eighth rest, and sixteenth rest. Next, how about the sofa syllable of the song? Okay, so it is very important for us to know the key of the song, to know also the lower do and the higher do, because it is very easy for us to determine the sofa syllable of the song. Okay, for example, the first note in our song is located in the second space. For example, your note is here in the second space. The key of the song is key of F. And I said that the do is in the first space and in the fifth line. Okay? If it is going up in the ladder or in this stuff, it is do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do. But if it is going down or descending, do, ti, la, so, fa, mi, re, do. I will repeat. If it is going up, it is going up rather, do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do. Okay? Do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do. If it is going down or descending, do, ti, la, so, fa, mi, re, do. Okay, ulitin ni ma'am. Do, ti, la, so, fa, mi, re, do. Bababa. Pagpaakyat naman. Do, re, mi, fa, so, la, ti, do. Okay? So, nakita natin, are ang lower do. Akyat tayo, space, line. Ganun yun. O kaya na may line, space. So, tingnan muna natin dito sa paakyat. Okay? Aran do. So, do, aring susunod na aring line ay re. So, ano ngayon nito? Magiging mi. Okay? Okay, if it is going down, it is do, ti, la, so, fa, mi. The same siya. Even you start in the lower do or in the higher do. Parehas yun ay magiging mi. So, kaya ganun kahalaga ang paghanap natin ng key ng isang awit para malaman natin kung saan natin ilalagay ang lower do at ang higher do. Tandaan, ang do dito ay movable. Ano ibig sabihin ng movable? Hindi man niya, ma'am, the do is in the third space. Kung key of C yun, no? So, it depends upon the key of the song. Okay, thank you.